Bob, it must have been a pretty moving moment for you, particularly, I would have thought, watching Gabby Giffords, given what you had been through yourself.
You know, I think all of us, I'm sure you're the same, you're pretty stunned and shocked that she showed up like that suddenly right there in the floor of Congress. You know, her recovery's been pretty remarkable, I have to say. I didn't really expect her to be out there alone, out there walking and speaking to those that were there. You know, the last time she even went public, in terms of visually, was just a release of a couple of pictures back about 3 months ago, shortly before, right before she got the part of her skull put back on. But now this time, suddenly out of nowhere, and she said this is the most important thing to her, to go ahead and vote on this extremely important issue that's been risen. She, you know, improved faster than people thought. But, I mean, the main point I wanted to say was that, you know, this is a long, long road to recovery, but you end up being better every year than you were before, even though there's some comments from certain insurance, especially that this improvement, you know, ends after a couple of years. But she's got the same thing. She's got, you know, injury to the left part of her head. She was actually shot right over here. The IED, you know, hit me on that side. My skull, called a craniectomy, was removed from this side so the brain can expand, so that the brain can actually breathe. And she's had exactly the same thing for the same exact reason. And it takes generally about 4 months before they put that back on because the brain has gone back to normal. And she's exactly the same thing. So in that sense, I had a pretty good idea of what she's feeling like, how she's speaking, how she's walking, and certainly her cognitive abilities of what she's able to think like and what she's to understand.